What's up, guys? Spud here at ClickBank. Today, we are going over how to build a landing page for paid Facebook traffic. So to get started, let's start with what are we talking about when we say landing page? You see this term thrown around all the time. A landing page essentially is a single page with a single focus. A landing page will often try to get a visitor's information and convert them as a lead, but in the affiliate marketing space, landing pages are more commonly used for a single purpose of what I like to refer to as a bridge. All we are trying to do, especially in this affiliate marketing space, is bridge a visitor from a traffic source and get them to a vendor's sales page. That is it. So this bridge, what you're essentially doing is connecting a pain, a curiosity, something that you are piquing attention and interest in on the traffic source side, and you are going to take them along and prepare them then to be sold a product. It's a very, very focused page, single-minded on that one goal. And today, that's what we're focused on. We're gonna look at taking a ClickBank offer and building a pre-sell page for Facebook ads traffic. Let's jump in. So today I'm using the offer GlucoTrust on ClickBank. You can find it in the marketplace. It's a high converting offer, top offers in the months of September. Let's dive in. This is their sales page that you're looking at right now. I always like to start here just to get a feel for color and overall feel. I really prefer to match my bridge page up with colors as much as I can so there's no jarring effect visually when the user makes the jump. So I'm gonna be using ClickBank Accelerator to build our landing page today, and I'm going to get started using a template, and I'm gonna click on new funnel. I'm building this landing page today based on the assumption that this visitor is gonna be coming from a paid Facebook ad. With that said, one of my favorite templates is a video pre-sell, especially when I'm linking up with a VSL, a video sales page from the vendor side, just like we looked at from GlucoTrust. So because of that, I'm going to select this video pre-sell template within Accelerator to get started. Once you click on it, it'll bring you into the funnel editor. The actual page we're editing today is right here. I'm going to click on edit page. Okay, so before I jump into the first thing we're going to be editing on this template that we have pulled up in Accelerator is a consideration around the paid Facebook traffic source. So really specifically, before I even start to look at my copy, I'm going to consider the audience that I'm targeting with my Facebook ad campaign and consider that before I even get started. So with GlucoTrust, I'm going to be targeting males specifically 40 plus that have an interest in blood sugar, diabetes, and weight loss. So just wanna lay that out before I even jump into considering copy. But copy is the very first thing I'm going to touch when it comes to this landing page. It's just how I like to structure my landing pages. And it's essentially the most important variable on your page when it comes to getting a user from your ad to your page to the vendor's landing page with your hop link from ClickBank. When I look at copy for a pre-sales video page, I love to first spend some time with the vendor's VSL. Spend some time watching through their VSL, look at the unique selling mechanisms that the vendor is using, unique hooks, anything that that sticks out to you as far as something that piques your curiosity during the beginning or any stage of the VSL is a great thing to pay attention to. Another quick pro tip is when you're on the vendor's page, a lot of times when you signal an exit and start to move around, you'll see pops like this that pop up. And a lot of times if you click on that pop-up offer, it's called an exit offer, you can click on that and it will actually reveal, sometimes it'll reveal an actual hybrid page and brand new page. Sometimes it'll just reveal additional content. In this case, it's revealing additional content on the page that I will then review, like testimonials, things that they're claiming about this product. Any type, especially pay attention to the pain that this product is solving for them. That really helps me generate more ideas related to the copy that I'm gonna be using for this pre-sales video page. Fire that exit pop, click on the link, and actually go to where the vendor is sending you. Use that VSL. The last tip I'll give you when it comes to diving into copy is I really like to go to the affiliate resources page. So I'm going to show that here. This is the GlucoTrust affiliate resources page. You can browse through. They oftentimes provide some great high-level information just about the offer, about demographics, about targeting, all that kind of stuff that will really help you tune your copy as well. But another really great thing to look out for is if they have email swipes. So if they have email swipes, it's another great place to mine for copy. So open that email swipe file up, start reading through those emails and get more inspiration for hooks, for pain points, for mechanisms that they're using within those email swipes. And you can get some great ideas there as well. So for the sake of time for this video today, let's assume I dove into the VSL, I dove into those email swipes, and I just went through that text version of the page after that drops down. I have reviewed all of that, I've picked out my favorite elements, and I've crafted an outline. That takes some time, typically about an hour for me personally. I really like to spend some time with all that, but for the sake of this video, I'm not gonna make you sit through an hour of me reviewing all of that content, and we're gonna dive straight into the outline that I kind of formulated after reviewing all of that content. Let's jump into adding that copy that we just outlined onto the template page inside of Accelerator. So the first thing I like to do is actually for a pre-sales video, a video pre-sale page, is actually add what I call a little ribbon at the top of the page using the bold statement module here that you just saw me drop in there. And it's right off the bat, it's a little big. So I'm gonna shrink this down using the spacing editor here. Shrink it down so that there's not as much padding on the top and bottom. Okay, that's a lot closer already. So I also, going back to the point around red at the beginning of this with GlucoTrust and aligning the look and feel, I like the idea of making this a nice red ribbon at the top that really sticks out. So I'm gonna add a red background to this. And in this case, a lot of times I will use like a hex code, like copy paste kind of a Google Chrome plugin. But for the sake of time, I'm just gonna be selecting a red that's as close as possible to that red that we saw on their page. So I'm gonna use their built-in image, built-in color selector on the background here. So let's make that red. Sweet, now I've got some white text over a red background. And I'm gonna go over and pull what I had outlined for this ribbon section, which is right here. Copy that, paste that into this section up here. Perfect. So right off the bat, you can see an angle that I'm going for is the combo of blood sugar and weight loss, and also bringing cells back to life. That was a unique selling mechanism that I saw as I reviewed their content. And so right off the bat, I'm trying to pique curiosity by almost like, yeah, asking a question to them. This 30-second bedtime secret supports healthy blood sugar and weight loss by bringing cells back to life. And putting that idea in the visitor's mind right off the bat, the goal of this line is nothing but to get them into my headline. That is the only goal for this line. I'm not trying to sell a product. I'm not trying to do anything else. This entire page, the way we're structuring this copy, is the goal of the first line is to get to the second line. The goal of the second line is to get to the third line and so forth. So all I'm trying to do is get them just enough curiosity to then read my headline. So that's the goal of this. And it's a little big. So I'm actually gonna go in here, I'm gonna shrink this font size down a little bit too. That's way too small. Let's go 30. Yeah, I like that. 36 is where it's at. I'm gonna stick to that. And one other thing you can do is highlight a particular point in that sentence. I'm using an underline to highlight that just to make sure you get their attention on the thing that you think is gonna pique the most curiosity. All right, so from here, one really cool thing about the GlucoTrust offer, on the left side of this page, one of the biggest elements that you see is that image, just that default play button there. What that is a placeholder for an image. And with a video pre-sales page, what we're trying to do with this image is we're trying to complement the copy. You're trying to align, again, you just sent them from an ad around an expectation around pain points related to weight loss, blood sugar, and now my unique selling mechanism is around cells. So with GlucoTrust, one really cool thing is when I went into their affiliate resources page, they had some really cool GIFs that were like animated images that had a play button already built in. I'm actually going to use that GIF that I found on their affiliate resources page right here in the place of this image. And the goal on a video pre-sales page for this image is to do nothing but get them to click. That's it. Like, so what's going to happen is we're going to put our hop link linked on this image so that when they go to click that image and play a video that you're going to sell on this page, that's the only thing we're selling. We're not selling a product. We're not selling anything else. We are selling to play a video. That is the goal of this page, the single goal. So I'm going to grab that GIF that I grabbed from GlucoTrust and their affiliate resources page, and I'm going to pop that in here. All right, awesome. Now that we have our image in here, you can see that play button. I picked this one again related to the hook that I chose around those cells, so that GIF is actually highlighting these cells. I'm going to start to taper in some of my other content that I outlined in my copy. So I'm going to jump back over to my copy doc, and I'm going to grab my headline next. And you'll see the headline I chose is again related to that hook. You'll see here, these cells that live on your pancreas could be the hidden root cause of your weight and blood sugar challenges. So again, I'm trying to increase curiosity around these cells, and especially tied to being the hidden root cause of your weight and blood sugar challenges. And again, I'm hitting on that pain. So at the same time, a huge function of these pages is actually disqualifying traffic. So let's say for some reason your ad creative was not on the mark and you were actually getting clicks that won't eventually convert on the VSL page. This bridge, again, as you walk across that bridge, you're saying, hey, like, is this the problem you're having? Are you looking for this type of solution? We're qualifying people at the same time. So not only are we trying to raise awareness around those pain points and the fact that we have a solution and creating curiosity around that, but you're actually trying to disqualify folks before they jump over to the sales page with your hop link. All right, now that we have our headline in, we're gonna drop in some supporting copy right under that. Again, I just raised some curiosity, and what I'm going to do in my copy is actually then highlight exactly what I'm talking about as far as what I've been trying to raise curiosity around, which is beta cells. So I'm dropping that right under my headline, and I'm gonna adjust this and make it definitely larger. That's still a little bit bigger. There we go. Actually, drop it down a little bit more. Cool. Beta cells. I'm going to italicize and underline that. Cool. So in this case, I have a headline, and I'm actually making a big claim around beta cells as another spike of curiosity, because most people have no idea what I'm talking about. And then I'm gonna go in and get them to continue reading after that with some supportive copy. All right, and right off the bat, one thing I am noticing is the padding here. As I added this text, my padding disappeared between that ribbon and this section. So I'm actually gonna go in here and add some padding, some spacing, to just make that breathe a little bit more so it doesn't feel as cramped. Yeah, like that. All right, cool. So this right off the bat, one issue I am worried about is that my copy is a little bit too large, and it pushed this CTA, which is a very important element for this page. I want that CTA to be visible above the fold. And again, above the fold is just it's a weird nerdy term for us marketers that we use to just say the viewable screen that the typical user will see on their screen. So it needs to be in that viewable area without scrolling. It looks like the copy I've outlined here, I either need to shrink it down enough to make room for it, or I need to eliminate some of it. So I'm gonna read through this and see what adjustments I can make and maintain the most important pieces of the copy, but shortening it enough to get that CTA above the fold. All right, so in this case, this second line, I think I can eliminate a little bit of copy here while maintaining the main point. So I'm going to take off however they can be brought back to life. And I'm going to eliminate this with this simple bedtime ritual and end it there to take off a couple more lines of text. All right, it's getting better. And I'm almost there. I like that my CTA is just barely visible. Another pro tip is what you can actually do inside this builder, and most builders, they have column formats, and most work within a column kind of a layout. And so you can also go in here and adjust the widths of your columns. So let's say I want more room from the text column. I can actually shift the column width over with this tool inside Accelerator to allow it to expand so that the text wrapping is not pushing my CTA as far down on the page. That's one trick you could use instead of using, kind of shrinking up your text size and things like that. In this case, another thing I'm going to do instead of, because I want that image to be the size that it is while creating as much space as possible on the right column. So in this case, what I'm actually going to do instead of changing my column size is I'm actually going to go back up to this ribbon that we started with at the top. I'm going to shrink this text back down to a single line and see if I can shorten this up so that it creates more screen area for my CTA to be visible. So I'm going to do that real quick. Almost there. Sweet. Now I'm on one line up there and my CTA button is now just barely visible. I like that a lot more. I think one other thing might do is shrink this up just a tiny bit to create a little bit more room. Perfect. All right, cool. Now we're getting there. I'm actually going to make this stand out a little bit more because I had to shrink it. I'm going to use a color to call this out instead of what we were using before, just the size. So I'm going to use a color using the red color to again, stay on brand. All right, I have just a little bit more copy related to watching the video that I need to fit in. So I'm going to shorten this down a little bit more and add that back in here. I think I'm going to have to shorten some of this copy as well. So I'm gonna take that out. I really wanted to make all of this fit. And as you can see, I'm having to cut a lot of this out or reshape the copy. This is a very common thing, but it's worth spending the time getting your copy just right. So that's why I'm messing with this. And you can see in this copy what I'm trying to do: highlight the beta cells, what their function is, highlight those bullets around the benefits of this offer that I'm about to send them to, get them primed and ready to watch this video. And here you can see in the copy, watch this video to learn how to fix this hidden root cause. And then right below this, I'm just gonna have a little PS. This is a really common tactic you'll also see around just like right before you send them over to the VSL page with your hop link, just one little bit to make it even more important that they make it there in their mind. So that's what I'm attempting to do with this. The spacing there is way too much, so I'm going to adjust this to single so I can press it. There's that. All right, now we're cooking. Okay, so as you can see, I would honestly make a few more adjustments, probably with this section right here to shrink it up a little bit more and get that CTA again above the fold. But for today, you get the point. We're trying to get that CTA up to above the fold or just visible so that at least they know the button is there. All right, so I'm gonna move on to my CTA. Again, I would really like to keep this on brand and match that red kind of theme that we have going on with GlucoTrust. So I'm going to go into my button settings and we're gonna do a couple things here. We're gonna edit the color. We're going to change this to red. There's defaults. There's also, you can always just pick a custom color as well, but I'm gonna pick red. I'm going to keep this a large button, but I'm also going to go full width. I like that. Margin at the top, I'm gonna take away so that, again, what I'm trying to do is bump this up as close as I can to that text so it's visible above the fold. And the last thing I'm gonna do is get my hop link, and that goes right here to the navigate to, and I'm gonna pop that in right there and save it, see how it's looking. Page will refresh and show us. I'm liking that. It's looking good. I'm noticing right off the bat here, my red is a little off, so I'm gonna make that the same red as the button. The goal of these pages is to take away anything that might create distrust, that this is something that cannot be trusted. And so even small things like your colors not quite matching right, spacing looking a little off, all those little things can make a buyer question, is this trustworthy? Like, is this person someone I should listen to? All that stuff. So you're trying to eliminate as many of those little psychological triggers that you can. So I'm gonna go in here, I'm gonna adjust our red to match that a little bit better, a little bit brighter. Save it. Sweet, that's looking a lot better. Yeah, and again, on the same theme, I would actually go and make this red the same red as all those, but yep, you get the point. The last thing on this pre-sales video page that I'm going to mention is actually a footer section real quick. Footer section, all you're wanting to do is essentially just add a little line of text down here on the bottom that it's the typical experience that you see, and it creates more trust because you'll put a privacy, and if you don't have a privacy page, go find a default one, Google it, get one, post it on a page, link to it in your footer. Also put a copyright thing, again, makes it more official, more trustworthy. The last thing on the footer that I will mention is for Facebook ads, the reason we're building this pre-sales page in this example, Facebook also likes to see a privacy policy link, and a lot of times you'll get flagged if you don't have one. Okay, to add a footer on this page, I'm just gonna use a pre-made template section, this visual list right here, and I'm gonna drop it down here at the very bottom. The reason I'm using this is to create these three columns down here with some text. What I'm actually gonna do is just eliminate these images within these sections so that I just get a nice three column text section here that I can start to edit. All of this stuff I don't need in this section that I just dropped in, so I'm gonna take it all off. And as you can see, after I eliminated those images and those additional text lines that we didn't need, I just have a simple three column text line here with a that section, and I'm gonna put a quick gray, yeah, I'm gonna use gray background on that, and there you go. You have a nice stock looking footer as the bottom of your page, and we are ready to use this. So the last step is the same hop link I used for the CTA. I'm gonna go here, make sure my video is also linked. So now we've got the link there, we've got the link there. Again, that is the whole purpose of this page. You've got this interesting little video thumbnail that pairs well with your copy on the other side and has a nice clear focus to get people to click and jump over to the video sales page for GlucoTrust from a Facebook ad. And there you have it, a brand new bridge page for your Facebook ads, a video pre-sales page. We hope this has been helpful. The last step is simply to grab that link, pop it into your Facebook ads campaign, and you're off and running. We also hope this has been a great behind the scenes look at ClickBank Accelerator landing page builder. It's also got some great email marketing features that you should also check out. The link will be in the description if you'd like to learn more about Accelerator. We hope this has been helpful. Thank you for tuning in. If you like this content, smash the like button. Hope you subscribe, and we will talk to you soon.